Thank you very much. Muchas gracias, Presidente. And first of all, dear all, I would like to say that I am really delighted to participate to this fourth symposium organized by you, by its president, Antonio Larden, but with so rich participation of key representatives of business leaders in Spain, but also beyond Spain, in particular our friend coming from Mexico. But I would like also to congratulate you for organizing so well this bridge with academies, and in particular with Dr. Maite Costa. I know very well at the time she was in charge of regulation in Spain, but I see this bridge extremely important at the time we have to develop evidence-based policy. And accordingly, this capacity to organize things in order to anticipate evolution of and trends and main trends affecting energy panorama is extremely important. And I know the important network Maria Teresa is leading with some other key actors in Europe. I would like this morning to pass three messages. First of all, we are not in Europe a sort of energy island. Accordingly, we have to take more into account global evolution. Second, I will comment to you the main achievement, the recent main achievement, and our vision regarding European energy policy. And I will finish with our main priorities, in particular this year. First of all, it is important to tackle key evolution in progress at global level. And let me say, we are reaching a sort of turning point. Energy markets are changing, not fast, but very fast. This is true when we are considering energy prices first. 1 year ago, we were in the middle of the second part of 2014 at a level of more than $100 per barrel, $115. Today, we are around $30 per barrel. So we are not speaking about a reduction of 10 or 15% or 20%, but more than 60%. Largely due to overcapacity. Overcapacity because of new producers and because of an economic growth going not at the level expected. Many new producers, not only in the United States, with all side, but also in Canada, in Australia, in Africa, Nigeria, Mozambique. This is valid also for gas, because oil prices are impacting more and more to gas prices. And again, for gas, we can see new producers, for example, in the Mediterranean area, with Egypt. The new discovery of gas in Egypt is estimated at a level of around 800 billion cubic meters. And it is only a start. But as you know, we have also new discoveries important in Israel, in Cyprus, and in other parts of Africa. And we have also the shale gas boom in the US. Regarding economic growth, obviously, the level expected in China is not there. And if you are considering, for example, it's a good barometer, the situation of steel in China, you can see an important reduction of consumption. And as a consequence, an overcapacity. Of course, my opinion is, in the following month, we will assist to some quasi automatic adjustment due to the decline of investment. And if economic growth will go in a more positive trend, prices, energy prices for oil and gas could well reach a new level more balanced. And it is important to have all these points in mind in order to anticipate that and to be ready at the right time. This is important for the strategy of the different companies. We had also, in terms of energy security, to manage the difficulties, the crisis between Russia and Ukraine, illustrating our dependence. As you know, for gas, we are importing a lot, more than 60%, and we have a dominant supplier. And as you know, the traditional approach of Russia is to organize the things through physical lines, and through physical lines to try to control prices, destination, quantities, and sometimes politics. Accordingly, our views are clearly oriented in three directions in order to reduce this dependence. First, to boost the LNG market. And as you know, we have in Europe, including in this country, in Spain, important infrastructure and capacities not very well used. And the LNG market is becoming more and more competitive, more and more liquid, with more and more producers. This should be a big chance for Europe. We are, and we will remain, the main importer in the world. With a market representing more or less around 400 billion cubic metrics per year. And with a declining internal European production. Look at the situation in the United Kingdom, but also the situation in the Netherlands, with an immediate declining of the level of production. Accordingly, we will have to import still important quantities of gas. And we should take advantage of this new evolution, completely new, of gas market at global level. This is a big chance for the main consumer we are representing. And we will present very soon a new strategy for that. Second, we should also accelerate the so-called Southern Corridor, I mean the Caspian gas arriving from the Caspian Sea to Europe. And as you know, we managed in order to facilitate important investment last year. The consortium is progressing well. What is important is to obtain significant quantities of gas and to pay attention to the evolution of Iran. Because one important thing last year has been the deal with Iran. Some were full of skepticism at the beginning. You will remember that. Europe has played an important role during the negotiation. And I personally detached one of our main nuclear experts in order to facilitate the negotiation. Accordingly, our opinion was very clear. Iran accepted a lot of concession in order to reduce the level of centrifugation, to reduce to one site enrichment process, to open the door to International Atomic Energy Agency inspectors, and also to manage that rapidly. Finally, including in US, the US Congress has been in situation finally to support it, convinced by the presentation of it, in particular by John Kerry and the US Secretary for Energy, Ernest Moniz. And now we will have the return of Iran to international market, probably more rapidly than expected by some experts. Because the main counterpart of this concession at the level of nuclear aspect will be the political will of Iran to come back rapidly to energy market, and probably first to LNG. And we could also envisage some possibility to have some quantities of Iranian gas in the context of the Southern Corridor. The third priority to reduce our dependence is more than ever the development of gas hub in the Mediterranean area. And as I said before, the new discoveries of gas are representing a big chance. At the same time, we would like, and I know this is important for you, for Spain, to relaunch a real energy partnership with Algeria. Algeria is full of reserves of conventional and unconventional gas. The challenge will be to convince our partner at a time long-term contract will approach the end of their life, to adapt the regulatory framework in order to facilitate the development of initiatives from European companies. And this is important in order to use fully the two gas pipes from Algeria to Spain and to organize the things in order to be in situation to exploit these quantities of gas in a more clever way at the level of European energy internal market. Accordingly, big evolution regarding energy market, big evolution regarding energy security, and last but not least, big evolution regarding sustainability. You refer rightly to COP21. COP21 has been a political success due to a very good management from the French presidency with the support of Europe and my commissioner, Miguel Arias Cañete. But the president of COP managed that very well, ensuring a political command, a clever political command of a negotiation, taking into account specificities coming from China or US. Donc we have a clear commitment from the global community, but now the challenge will be that of implementation. And we should pay a particular attention in order to facilitate development of all these aspects at global level, because as you know, we are not representing a lot in terms of emission. Europe is representing around 10%, and in a few years, we'll represent 5% or even less percent of global emission. But nevertheless, one new element in Paris has been a clear new understanding of the crucial role of energy policy. And it was time. Because, as you know very well, the production and the use of energy are representing more than 60% of global emissions. Accordingly, without adapting energy system, without pushing innovation in the context of clean energy technologies, it will be completely impossible to finish successfully. And it was also important, in parallel of formal negotiation, to open the door to business, industry, and finance, as well as the global society. Because without industry, without finance, it will be impossible also to finish successfully and we should manage things in order to obtain important results in the context of decarbonization, but profitable for the economy and the society. So this is the schema, with important changes affecting energy and, more largely, our economy. In the front of climate change, in the front of security, but also taking into account radical changes affecting global energy market. In front of us, of that, our views is clear. As you know, we have presented a new vision of energy union, and vision is extremely important. Sometimes it's a lack of vision which is at the origin of big difficulties in Europe as well as at global level. Accordingly, our vision for energy, after consulting all our partners, is oriented in five directions. First of all, the consolidation of energy security, implementing the strategy I mentioned before. Second, consolidating and reinforcing European energy internal market, extremely important both for competitiveness and for security and for sustainability. And we will present important reform in the course of this year. I will come back to that. Third, tackling all the aspects of energy efficiency and moderation of demand. And this is also important. Of course, managing in a clever way decarbonization. I would like to mention that in Europe, we are producing already today 54% of our electricity without CO2. We are the only one big actor in situation to produce already today, not in 2020 and 2030. 54% of our electricity without CO2 due to the addition of renewables, 27%, and nuclear, 27%. We will also give a push to innovation and technologies. Because again, there is a lack in Europe of capacity to use fully the knowledge. We are splendid regarding breakthrough in terms of fundamental research, but there is a lack of capacity to organize links between, for example, energy sector, scientific organization, and industry. And frankly, I would like not to repeat the situation we had with photovoltaic. Europe, being the first in the world in terms of installed capacity, but all equipment in terms of industrial devices produced in Asia and mainly in China. We should not repeat that, and we should learn lessons from experience for that. And this will be extremely important. And let me say, we had also opportunity to progress in different fronts. I mentioned the deal with Iran. We managed in order to avoid any disruption of supply of Ukraine, being the mediator between Russia and Ukraine during two winters, last one and this one. And as you know, we have to pay permanent attention to that. It's extremely difficult negotiation. But we had also the opportunity to progress significantly regarding interconnection and energy infrastructure. We managed during the European and before the European summit adopting the new 2030 framework for energy and climate. We finalized an agreement between Spain, Portugal, and France. we had the opportunity to consolidate that after the inauguration of INELF, the new electricity interconnection, doubling the capacity at the frontier France-Spain. And we organized just after that a summit in Madrid with the Prime Minister of Spain and Portugal and the President of France and the President of the European Commission. But we have been in a situation to do the same in other parts of Europe, for example, for finalizing an agreement for a new big interconnector, gas interconnector between Poland and Baltic States, signed in the presence of the President of the Commission and all President and Prime Minister of the region, just before the European Council in October, last October. I was in Vilnius for electricity, for inauguration of two new important interconnections, already operational, between Sweden and Baltic States and Poland and Baltic States, adding 1,200 megawatts of capacity. And this is fundamental for countries still dependent to the Russia grid. As I said, any time we are progressing along these fronts, this is a signal of solidarity, bringing countries closer and population closer. Donc, the impact is extremely important. And to finish, we will have the most important energy program we never had this year. In a few days, February 10, we will present a first package dedicated to gas energy security with the new strategy LNG and storage, but also a strategy heating and cooling, and two review of legislative document, in particular the security of supply gas regulation, shifting from national to regional approach, and the review of the intergovernmental agreement in order to ensure full compliance between IGA, intergovernmental agreement, and EU legislation, in particular energy security provision. This was a mandate received from the European Council, the European leaders, all, and we will present that to the European Council and the European Parliament in the following days. We will have a new package, important, before the end of summer, dedicated to Energy Efficiency Directive and Performance Building Directive, because as you know, building and housing sector are representing around 40% of energy consumption, and accordingly, it's important to progress in that direction and to develop all aspects regarding regulatory framework, but also innovation and new technologies. And we will finish with a review of renewables directive and a new market design for European energy market, in particular for electricity. Why? Because we are considering largely beyond any you see concept. Not speaking about concept. I'm speaking about a new capacity to analyze the things and to respond to new needs. The situation regarding electricity is changing rapidly. 5 years ago, we had not 27% of electricity generated from renewables. Accordingly, there is a need to manage variability. There is a need to give to, for example, storage a new priority in order to ensure the stabilization of the grid. There is a need to incorporate flexibilities and demand response. There is a need to secure markets. And as you know, we are assisting now to different national capacity mechanisms. We would like to shift from national to regional approach with common principles. In particular, all these systems should be open to cross-border participation and should be technology neutral. At the same time, the basis will be the coupling market, the network code, and new approach for balancing market. I am convinced we can save a lot shifting from national zone to regional balancing zone. And I am confident, due to our very good cooperation with regulators, very well, Council of European Regulators, the agency, ACER, but also TSO, Transmission System Operator, and all the operators regrouped into Eurelectric, as it is with Eurogaz. And second, during international fora, G7, G20, Clean Energy Ministerial, last time in Merida, Mexico, we see the same demand arriving from different continents. I mean, not only to support increasing role of renewables, but also to ensure, through a new set of common rules, a capacity of markets to take that on board in the right way. Securing markets, boosting cross-border trades, facilitating incorporation of new renewable energy, but at the same time, giving more certainty to investors. And this will be important. I was also in Washington at the beginning of the year. I had a meeting with the president of FERC, Federal Energy Regulatory Authority, Dormambe. They are thinking in the same, on the same way. And I think it will be important to see Europe maintaining a role of leadership. It's important not to be followers, but follow, but in situation to open a new route, and we should do that in the context of an increasing level of international cooperation. With our colleagues in North America, but also Central and Latin America, as well as with many other countries in Africa or in Asia. And another challenge will be energy for Africa. At a time, still quasi 1 billion of people have not access to electricity. And accordingly, we should also take that into account, because as you know, energy is impacting not only to quality of life, but also to security. And in the present time, this is more important than ever. And I look forward to implement that in close cooperation with you and all of our stakeholders. And accordingly, I would like to thank you very much for your attention. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Very good. Thank you very much. We are short of time, but perhaps we have some time if there is any questions. One, two, not more. No. No. One question?
Yes,
please.
Thank you very much, Dominique, for your very interesting presentation. You cover plenty of different sectors, subsectors on the energy, but coming from an oil company, I think I'm obliged to ask you something related to a part of the oil business. You talk about the outcome of the COP21, but I think that there is a great challenge for our industry, particularly for our refining industry. We see other parts of the world where people is trying to implement certain strategies in order to rationalize our sector. What's the mind, or what do you have in mind within the Commission in order to implement a similar strategy within Europe?
Thank you.
Thank you for your question. I will say the following. I am convinced regarding the importance to maintain in Europe this type of activities. We need a performant, solid and robust refining sector in Europe. First point. And this has been, for the first time, illustrated at the occasion of a presentation of the European Energy Security Strategy in the mid-2014. And it is not natural to present that, this type of text, to our leaders. Second, I am also well impressed by the restructuration already managed by many companies in that regard, addressing the challenge of sustainability. We should pay attention now to some aspect of competition with external actors. We should manage the things in order to give a real chance to our industries in that regard. I will facilitate the development of an active dialogue for that between the European Commission and industrial actors. In particular, we will develop the Refining Forum, regrouping all key representatives of this sector, and if the challenge is important, I am confident with our common capacity to identify solutions. And you see, when ExxonMobil decides to invest 1 billion euros in Europe, close to Brussels, in Antwerp, it is not only through generosity, I don't know, it is because they have the feeling this will be economically viable. Accordingly, I think we have in front of us some new possibilities to well address that, and I will facilitate this approach in close contact with some of my colleagues, having also responsibility for managing this aspect. Donc, I would like to invite you and to confirm my invitation to participate to this meeting, and my intention is to organize that in the following month. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Bueno, quizás si no hay nada más, porque me indican que vamos un poco mal de, bueno, mal de tiempo, siempre se va en un simposium, pero esto suele ser señal de que las cosas son interesantes.
Yes, and I would like to confirm this energy evolution or transition has to be seen as a real and managed as a real economic opportunity, profitable at the end of the day to the whole society, to the whole society, to the economy and to the whole society. And this should only be organized with your contribution and your support. Thank you very much.
I agree. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you.